Hey guys and gals, Nary here from Drakewing Gaming, and a sub you may on Twitter, the Gaming Dragon. Today I'm coming back at you with a Let's Play episode of Homecoming. So y'all, before we jump into it, just want to let y'all know our Patreon is now for as little as $5. Y'all can help support the channel, get some awesome rewards like permanent access to our community Discord server and full access to upcoming Not Safe for Work videos. Also, y'all, we're having a movie night officially on October 5th, Thursday. It's about 7 p.m. Eastern Central, Eastern Central Time? Yeah. Eastern Central Time, I think is what it's called. But, yeah, we're going to be watching one of my favorite horror movies, VHS. So, like I said, membership is as little as $5. You don't want to pop in, watch the movie with me, get on voice chat. I'll be there. We'll have a good time. Anyway, y'all, let's go ahead and jump right back in. Alarm chain, you were up. Whew, let's go. Sorry, I just got done doing crunches. All right. It's called a summer vacation for a reason, dumbasses. Come on, Tora. It's not that bad. Easy for you to say, man. You've never struggled with it like I do. What do you mean? It takes me so long to read things. I don't know, it's like... the words get mixed up in my head sometimes. I think I'm seeing one thing, but it turns into something else in my mind. Huh. Has it always been this way for you? Yeah. I don't know what's wrong with me. All I know is having to do homework all the time is torture. Hey, don't say that. I stand up from the bed and walk over to him. I'm about to help you out with it this summer. The work you get can't be any different from mine, right? You mean that? Of course I do. I don't want to see you struggling, man. For a moment, it looks like he's about to burst into tears, but then... Duh, you're the best, Hiro. It's so great having you back in Minnesota. I can't breathe. He's holding me too tight. Let's promise to make this the best summer ever, okay? You got it. The smile he's giving me right now. It's so genuine. So authentic. I've been away from home for too long. I may live in Osaka, but Minnesota has always been home to me. Now I'm reconnecting with my best friend. All right, where should we start? Wait a second. You mean we're gonna just start doing homework right now? That's right. Duh! Oh. About to say, did he go down on him? Yep, this is definitely going to be the best summer vacation ever. Oh, I can imagine why. No, no gay thoughts, no! My eyes are already heavy by the time I lay in my futon. Lazily, I give my stomach a gentle pat, satisfied from the filling meal Grandpa prepared. Heh, I didn't think I could be so hungry. I never usually eat that much. Pushing those thoughts out of my mind, I instead decide to focus on the events of today. Can't believe I'm back. My friends are here. I raise a hand upwards before curling it into a fist as if I were grabbing hold of something. It's real. I'm really here. I'm home, where I've always felt a sense of belonging. A single tear emerges, rolling down the side of my face, but I ignore it. After all, it's not a tear of sadness. I'm so glad to be back. As sleep overtakes me, I let my lips curl into a smile. I can't wait to see what tomorrow will bring. Okay. What does tomorrow bring? Beautiful sky. August 3rd. You liar. It's October 1st. There. That should do it. I finished packing my backpack with interesting things to take to Torihiko's house. Oh, are you heading out, Hiroyuki? I can't hide my excitement. I can feel my tail wagging side to side behind me. Yeah, Grandma. I'm going to visit Torihiko today. Grandma looks disappointed as she tries hiding a book behind her back before I can notice it.
I see. Hmm? What's that you have behind you? It's nothing that I can't wait for later. Go, dear. Have fun with your friends.
Are you sure?
I can... No, no. I don't want to hold you up. You only have so much time left in your summer vacation. You should spend time with Torihiko. He's waited a long time to see you again.
With a small, frail hand, she gently pushes me towards the door.
Okay, I'll see you later, Grandma.
Huh, kind of feel bad now. Looks like she wanted to show me something.
Huh, why does it have to be so hot in Minnesota?
Either my memory is hazy or I never realized how hot it actually was here.
Ooh.
I raise the hem of my shirt and start flapping it around, trying to create a breeze underneath. No matter what I do, the heat remains.
So hot. Hiroyuki?
Like, you know, water time.
Mm. Oh, God, I love that water. What? Can't a guy cool down in peace? You don't look so good. Kyoji, what are you doing here? God, I love his updated sprite. It looks so good. It looks so much better. I live here, silly. Oh. I rubbed the back of my head in embarrassment. I gently moved my wet hand back down, rubbed against my pants. Ah! Why must nature curse me with such disgusting bodily function? Hiro? Sorry, bad habit. Mm-hmm. Well, to answer your question, I'm on my way home. Oh, from practice? Mm-hmm. Ah, how did it go? Well, it was fine. He answers in an unusually quick tone. Did anything interesting? Well, say, would you like to have breakfast with me at the Ramon? Huh, that's weird. Sure, I skipped breakfast today. But it's getting kind of late for it now. It's almost like he's dodging the question. Sure, I wouldn't mind getting out of this heat. I let out a dry laugh after painfully reminding myself of the sweltering weather. That was dumb, Hiro. Nice going. Excellent! Kyoji claps both his hands together. Well, follow me, I'll lead the way! Okay. So, are you enjoying your summer vacation? Of course, Kyoji. I'm back in my hometown seeing all my friends again. Haven't had this much fun in a long time. Flashes of my life in Osaka pass through my mind. There's nowhere else I'd rather be than here.
Well, that's good. I'm glad we're able to make you feel welcome again.
I'm curious, though. I've never been to a big city. What's it like in Osaka? Oh, no, not this question. Please, Kyoji. Not now.
Hmm?
Hey, isn't that Koya over there walking into the corner market?
Oh?
Oh, indeed it is. We should invite him to lunch with us.
Oh, good idea. Let's catch up with him.
We nod our heads in agreement and start running after Kuya.
Kuya!
Huh? Well, if it isn't Kyoji and Hiroyuki. Fancy seeing you two here.
We were on our way to Ramon for breakfast. Would you like to join us?
What?
Yeah, it'll be fun.
I'll pass.
Hmm? Huh? Was it something I said?
I'm not feeling up to it today.
I see. That's too bad. Aw, come on, Kuya. I'm only around for a month. Don't you want to spend some time with me while I'm still around?
You have a point. I lean in closer to give him a teasing look. So, what'll it be? Huh. Alright, you convinced me. Happy?
Yay!
I can't hide the huge grin I have on my face right now. You're such an idiot sometimes, Hiroyuki.
I'm glad you're joining us, Kuya. We should hurry up if we plan to get good seats, though. It's getting close to the seniors' hour.
The what?
It really has been a while since you were last here, Hiro. Hey!
You're right about the seniors' hour. I guess what I'm doing can wait.
He looks off into the distance as he says that. Something else is clearly on his mind, but...
Come on, let's go.
Kuya places the handbasket he was carrying on top of the others near the entrance and follows us out of the store.
So, then I said I'll call you sometime, okay?
You certainly have a way with women, Kuya.
You know it. All it takes is a wink to make their hearts melt.
Indeed.
Don't act like you haven't had your share of girls either, Kyoji. Whatever happened between you and Sayu?
Hmm? Who's Sayu? My ex-girlfriend. Things didn't work out. It's for the best, I think.
Okay, now water time.
I'll have some good water. We both decided we need time to see other people.
That's too bad. You two were quite the power couple last year.
Don't say that. We're normal people, just like everyone else.
Sure, Mr. Star Soccer Player. If anyone could bag the student council president, it's you. From where I'm sitting, I can clearly see Kyoji blushing.
Well, it's just...
I'm just messing with you. I know what you mean about things not working out with someone. It happens to me all the time. I see you two have been busy while I was gone. You could say that. I've had more girlfriends than I can count at this point. How about you, Hiro? How's Osaka been treating you? You meet any hot girls there?
I'm sure the dating pool's quite large.
I bet you're dating some bombshell rabbit, aren't you? I knew it! Hiroyuki, you're such a dog!
Hey, wait a sec! I'm a fox! And aren't you a dog too?
I'm a husky. Get it right. Kuya takes a drink from his soda while giving me a sidelong glance.
For the record, I know I'm not seeing anyone back in Osaka. In fact, I've never been on a date before.
What?
With a free hand, Kyoji uses his chopsticks to mess around with the leftovers on his plate.
Well, we're gonna have to change that while you're here, aren't we? So what are you into? I bet you like cats, huh? There are a couple hot ones at our school in Kazunari. Maybe I'll try setting you up with one of them. She kind of owes me a favor.
Crap, they've got me cornered here. How do I explain to them that I'm, Kuya, give him some space.
What?
Can't you see you're making him uncomfortable?
Oof. Saved by Kyoji the last second.
I respect your decision to stay single, Hiroyuki. It takes a lot of guts to do that in this day and age.
Thanks. Sorry, Hiro.
Don't worry about it, Kuya. It's not a big deal.
Right. He glances at the front door.
Jeez, I hope that didn't make him angry. Hey, Kuya, can I ask you something?
Sure.
I haven't seen you around town much since summer started. What have you been up to?
I have a job now.
Oh? Where at? Is something wrong? You're not having money problems, are you?
Whoa! I lean back in my chair. After slamming the table, Kuya sticks his face close to Kyoji. It's none of your business!
Hey, calm down. It was just a...
I don't have time for this. Thank you for breakfast, guys. He reaches into his pocket and places some money on the table. There's my share of the bill. I look over at Kyoji in shock. All I can do is stare out the window.
Everyone else in the restaurant is looking at us now. What just happened?
I shake my head to regain my senses.
Kyo just snapped. What should I do?
Talk to Kyoji. Not going with Kuya yet.
Kyoji! I'm fine, Hiroyuki. I should have known better than to ask Kuya that.
I'm sorry.
What for? This is your first week back. It's understandable for you to not know the situation everyone is in. I feel so bad about this. Don't! It's not your fault. The things are out of your control.
He looks over at me and smiles.
I think I know what's going on.
Huh? What do you mean?
At the moment, he just needs some space. Hey, wait a second. That's not answering my question.
He dismisses me by taking a long drink from his cup. It's like, you know, water time. Well, that's good. So that's how it's gonna be, huh?
Well, I'm afraid so. When Kuya's ready, I'm sure he'll tell us.
Leave me in suspense. I thought we were friends. Look across the table at him with pleading eyes.
I know what you're trying to do, Hiro. Taro does that to me all the time.
What? How is it that everyone's able to read my mind lately?
Oh, I wouldn't say that. I think I have a natural talent for understanding people's actions.
Really? So, are you saying you have us all figured out? That is pretty interesting. I wonder if I can get some juicy information about my friends out of him.
I suppose I do, in a sense.
I lean back in my chair. Got him right where I want him.
I see.
I proceed with the smoothest voice I can muster.
Would you care to tell me a little bit about the others, then? Nishimura? I've never took you for the kind who likes to gossip.
What?
I'm not that way, I swear!
Kyoji claps his hands together and smiles.
Well, I don't see the harm in telling you a few things. Who would you like me to start with?
Torihiko. Yeah, boy. Tell me a little bit about Torihiko.
Oshima has big dreams, but doesn't know how to reach them. Even though he wears a cheerful face, deep down he hides enormous self-doubt. I'm glad you came back when you did, Hiro. Perhaps all he needs is guidance from an old friend.
Huh, I never would have gotten that from just looking at him.
Anyone else you'd like to hear about?
Juichi. Anything interesting with Juichi?
Mikazuki prefers to hide his feelings. It's not because he doesn't have any. Rather, it's because he feels too much. If you give him enough space, he'll come around eventually.
I nod my head in understanding. That explains why he gets so angry when Torihiko teases him.
Thanks for sharing with me, Kyoji. There's no problem, Hiroyuki. What about Saitaro? You two seem to spend a lot of time together.
Alright, y'all, I'm gonna go ahead and pause it right there. Thank y'all so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, ring that notification bell, and check out our Patreon if you can. It always helps. Anyway, I love you all. I'll see y'all in the next video. Bye-bye!